Hello everyone, welcome back again to Acrylic painting lesson. So please make sure you subscribe my channel so you can follow up all my videos. Today I'm going to paint a flamingo painting. So for the starters, I just drew few outlines of flamingos the way I like to do. So let's start and see. I will start with the background and I'm going to do the sky with light blue, of course. Like this way, and I'm not going to color the flamingos. I'm going around them, so I will just bring the outline like this way. I'm going to use only light blue color to the sky. This is the line, and I'm going to color like it. Because my target is to use a lot of pink color and red and white to the flamingos, so I am trying to avoid doing much more the same color on the sky. In between I will add a little bit darker blue also, so I don't want to leave it like 100% same light blue. Just highlight it a little bit darker blue, and some place maybe a little bit white color if you like. So when you look at this painting, now I've made some places a little bit extra lighter white. If you see, it's not totally blue color or light blue color. I add a little bit white color also. It's a sky, so I just want to give a nice effect. You can do is, you can use the brush. Make sure your brush is a little bit wet, so easy for you to blend it. Not too much wet, just dip it on the water, that's enough. And just highlight with few colors that you will be liking. Just play around with white and blue, it will be much more nice. At this moment, my sky is already finished. So, I covered all the areas now in the sky. Later on, as if I change my mind, I will add something different. So, at this moment, my sky is ready. Now, I'm going to the bottom part, but not the flamingo. I'm doing the ocean. So, I'm going to do the down part, the background. Let's start with the background. So, let's start with the background. And remember one thing, my favorite acrylic paint brand is Fabio. It's very nice and I'm always using. So, of course, if you want to buy, you can always buy from my studio. And this is something that my favorite. It's very easy to blend and I like the high gloss effect. So now I'm going to use aqua color, and in the edge, of course, I'm going to make the line perfectly. When kids doing it, you don't need to force yourself like to have a perfect line. It's fine to have a little bit up and down because it's water area. So lines are not perfect, so you can always play around with the paint the way you like. So now what I will be doing is I am blending two to the colors together, not only this one. I am going to add a little bit blue color onto the aqua color. You can see. And I will highlight it with a little bit white color also. Not just aqua color, I'm just playing around with the different colors. If you like, you can add a little bit purple color also. It's giving a nice effect, if you see. As a beginner, I will recommend you to go near the edges of the flamingo. Use a small brush instead of a big brush, because for me it's fine, because I can control my brush strokes and I know where the lines are going. So the bottom part full, I'm going to do the same technique. Long lines are very nice. It will be automatically blending, so you don't need to keep rubbing it together. So my background is almost done. So now I'm going to do is the flamingo. So because I already colored it in different colors, the edges, I'm going to use white color first to the flamingo, so I know where is very nicely how to outline it. So I'm going to use white color acrylic paint first for the flamingos. And then I will start to color with the pink and reds. So let's color. First with white color. See, like that way. So every flamingo I'm going to first color with white color and then I will color with the pink. now I'm playing with little bit white and pink color on the first flamingo. So if you want, you can use little bit purple and highlight it also, but not too much, because just to highlight it, don't keep it total pink color. I'm using white and pink, so just you can fix the edges with nice brush strokes. So first flamingo is done. I just need to make the mouth and everything, but I will leave it that and I will go to the next flamingo, and then again I'm going to use a little bit red color and pink color. See, I'm just playing around with 2 to 3 different colors. And it's better you use a point brush so it's easy for you to blend the colors. If you like, of course, just a little bit purple color to highlight it, but it's not should be showing too much. Second flamingo is done too. Let's start with the next one. So I'm back again. You can see it's still not done. I only finish up like 6 flamingos. I still have 2 flamingos to finish. So I was thinking, let's do with you that flamingo. I will do with you. I'm using this pink color. Actually, I'm using 2 to 3 different pink colors. So you can find. I like little bit magenta pink and red and white mixing together pink. If you like, as I said, you can add a little bit purple also. If you see that your finger pencil lines are still showing, you can add little bit, another one layer of paint, it will be going away. 2 layers of paint, so the finger, pencil lines will be covered. Sometimes when we do the outliners, we try to press hard the pencil, so the pencil mark will be showing and it look kind of ugly. When you feel like your brush is too much with paint, instead of washing, you can wipe it away, because you need to have the same color to blend with the next color that you're using. For example, having pink color in the brush is totally fine. When you use the white color, you can blend it automatically. One is done. Let's go to the next flamingo. I'm going to do that one also in red color. It's going to be much more nicer, that's why. In case if you want to have a 3D effect, you can add a little bit extra paint onto the brush and leave it like this way. So Once it gets dry, it have a little bit 3D effect of the paint. If not, of course, you can use modeling paste mixing with acrylic paint. It's not that much hard, you just need to have a little bit patience. Hope you guys are going to enjoy this painting. It's very easy, and now we will going to do the other parts. Let's see what we will be doing in the background. You cannot just do the flamingos and keep. Okay, our flamingos are done. I hope you guys like my flamingos. Let's start with the legs, face, every other part now. half of the mouth we are going to cover with the white color, and then another half we will do with the black color. Okay, now the black color part will be covering. Like this way, it's going to cover all the mouth. So once the eyes mouth is done, you have to make the eyes. So you can do it is just to make sure you in your brush the back side. You just dip it and stamp it like this way. That's it. Very easy. So I will make it closer. You can see how the eyes and mouth, everything is done. Let's start with the legs now. I'm going to use black color. And when you're using black color, you can, if you like, you can use add a little bit gray color or white together and make it little bit gray and use it instead of totally black color. You can just use two colors together. This is very easy. You just need a pointer brush without pressing little bit. Now, because the flamingos are in the water, you cannot leave the legs like that way. It looks like legs are in the air. So what you can do is, you can just use some nice colors. Fix the edges of flamingos like this way. You can see exactly below the feet. You can now play with little bit purple color if you like, and of course you can add little bit pink and purple, so it will look like the shadows of the flamingos in the water. So I'm just adding some shadows, so it will show like this. Below the water there will be shadows from mangoes. Their shadow should be, so I'm going to use the same colors, like the same. Don't need to blend it, okay, just leave it overlapping, it's look nice. Isn't it nice? Because you're applying a lot of layers of paint, so it looks so nice when it finish. Okay, now let me light this way. Let's start to do some nice leaves and branches now. So I'm now doing some leaves. So I'm going to use first darker green. In here I'm making some bushes, so it's come downwards. So so if you see, it's not in perfect line, I'm just making some longer, some shorter, like this way. So now it's easy for me to do is, I'm making some leaves, I'm using a pointer brush by the way. See, it's very easy, not that much hard. So now in between, I'm not going to leave it like this way. I'm going to do is, I have the same green color brush in my hand. I'm taking a little bit white color to that and just making some lines like this way. Don't make it like straight, just make it like it's almost falling out. If you see, it's already going over my branches also. Don't forget, when you're doing this, you need to make sure that you subscribe my channel already, so you can see all my new videos. See, that's enough. So I will leave it now like that way. I want to make some flowers, but I want to make sure that paint is dry. So I'm going to leave the paint like that way, and I'm going to go to this side and start the other part. So I'm going to do is now lighter green. Some banana leaves I'm going to make here. I'm using lighter green, but instead of lighter green, I'm going to use a little bit darker green together. Not totally lighter green I'm going to use. See, it's mixing together and giving a nice effect. It's very easy, not that much hard. Now what I will be doing, I'm using little bit white to the same brush. From the middle, I will just make one line. I like this way. So I will make another one leaf on the side, same way. This way. If you see, it's very simple. You don't need to put a lot of things. I'm going to make now little bit coconut tree leaves. So I'm using black gray color. It's going to be like this way. Over the banana leaf I'm going to make. If you see, I'm using a point brush, it's easy then for me to fix the edges of the branch. See, like this way. It's very easy. If you see, it's not that much hard. So let's go back to this side because it's almost dry in this area. I'm making few flowers in here. I don't want to keep it empty. So last part now, if you see my canvas, it's totally filled, but this part is kind of empty. So I'm going to do is I'm going to make some few water lilies with these colors, because I have few colors also remaining in my canvas. Let's enjoy the last part. So, what do you think? Our painting is almost done. I think we are done. So, for today, I'm done. I hope you guys enjoyed today's painting. It's very easy, not that much hard. You see, it's very simple painting that we did. It's flamingo painting. I hope you guys will love it. And thank you for watching my video. Make sure you subscribe my channel. See you next time.